Hey, I'm Charles with Rocky Mountain. Today I'm going to be showing you how to install a Tusk Stage 2 upgrade kit on your Polaris Pro XP. Now the Stage 2 kit, this comes with some premium features to help your side-by-side stand out and give you a more comfortable ride. So what's included in this kit is a removable full windshield. This thing's polycarb and scratch resistant. You're going to get the pivot folding mirrors. Those things just pop out of the way if you accidentally hit anything, and you can pop them right back out. You're also getting the Force aluminum roof. That's a staple item for any side-by-side. And you're gonna be getting the polycarb rear window. Now, this thing's gonna help enclose the cab and keep some of the elements out. So those are the items that are coming in the kit. Now let's go ahead and get them installed. Right here we have the mirrors. We're gonna start out by installing these. So this is the mounting kit that comes with your templates as well as a drill bit, which means you're also gonna need a drill. We also have a 16 millimeter combo wrench, a 15 millimeter socket, 8 millimeter Allen socket, then a couple common hand tools. So we've got an alignment punch, a Sharpie, and we're using some soapy water. We're gonna start on the driver's side. So the first thing we need to do is pull this rubber boot up and out of the way. And we've got a speaker wire in here. We're gonna disconnect this connection. There's a little tab you're gonna press down on. Then we're gonna remove both of the A-pillar bolts. And we're not gonna reuse these, but there's some Nylock nuts on the backside that will be reused. Next, I'm gonna install the mirror mount. So first we need to prep it. So we're gonna remove this jam nut. Then we've got the two M10 by 50 millimeter bolts. Those are gonna go through the cage. And if they don't line up very good, you can always use an alignment punch to get the cage lined up. Then we're just gonna use the stock Nylock nuts. And we'll tighten both bolts down. Then we'll go ahead and do the same process on the other side. Next, we need to drill a hole into this rubber boot. Obviously, ours is already done, but we're still gonna show you the process. So to do that, we're starting on the passenger side. So we're gonna use the passenger side template. This is just a sticker. And we're gonna line it up with the lines on this boot. So with that lined up, you know, I'm just gonna use the drill right into this. You can see where you're supposed to, but if you want, you can poke that little piece out and mark it with a Sharpie. And then with your drill, you know, obviously we're using that drill bit that came in our kit, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you don't damage anything when you drill through, because this boot is pretty close to that A-pillar and you've got these wires behind there. So just make sure you keep track of those and keep them out of the way. And a slow speed is gonna work best when you do this. Then we'll go ahead and do the same process on the other side. Now I can take the rubber boot, and I'm gonna install the speaker wire first so I don't forget. And then we can take some soapy water, just spray that around the edge of the rubber boot, and it's gonna help to pop that back into place. And the first thing we're gonna worry about is getting the hole over that stud. So I'll go ahead and clean some of that soapy water off. And after that, we've got two O-rings we're gonna apply grease to and then set in the two grooves on that stud. Then we can wipe off any excess grease, reinstall the jam nut, make sure the flat side is facing out. So we're gonna thread the mirror on. Then once you have it pretty close to where you need it, you can go ahead and lock it down with the jam nut. Then Then we'll go ahead and do the same process on the other side. Next, we're gonna install the roof. So to get this installed, we have a 5mm Allen and 13mm combo wrench. And then, you know, this is the hardware that comes with the kit. So you've got 4 spacers, 4 washers, 4 nylock nuts, and 4 bolts. And then you're gonna have 3 foam tape strips. Now with these strips, this is the bigger strip, and this bigger roll actually has 2 shorter strips in it. And then we're using soapy water to clean the roll cage, and you wanna refer to the instructions throughout the process. So we're gonna start out by cleaning off the roll cage with that soapy water and a rag. Then we're gonna remove the backing from the longer piece of foam tape, and we're gonna go across the front on the top of the roll cage. And then we'll do the shorter 2 strips on the sides. And we'll finish the roof installation once we install the other accessories. To start out the process, we've got a 39-inch foam strip in this windshield kit that's going to go across the top of the filler panel. Now with these foam strips, for me, it's easiest to stick one side down and then peel the rest of the backing off of it, lay it all in a straight line, and press it down. Now that we have the foam tape in place, we're going to take the 2 bolts, washers, and nylock nuts over to the machine and install the filler panel. The filler panel is going to mount up to these pre-existing holes in these gussets right here. So we're just going to set this in place. Then we've got a washer on one of those bolts. We'll go through both of those holes and install the nylock on the back side. Next, we're going to remove the protective film from the inside of the windshield. So the inside is the side where these bottom corners, they fold in. Now for the protective film on the outside, we're just going to peel it back a couple of inches. And then from there, we can install the bulb seal onto the window. Now with this, keep in mind, the seal itself is going to be facing the inside. And then if this fits loose at any point, you can always squeeze this together and it's going to fit tighter. Now with this bulb seal, I like to just get it started all the way across and make sure it's centered, and then I can finish pressing it on the rest of the way. And then if you have any extra length, you can go ahead and trim that off. Now that we have the bulb seal in place, we're going to take the knob, set that washer on there, and then we have this little rubber grommet. Press that down, and we're going to take a Sharpie. We're going to set the windshield in place. We'll put the knob through the top and screw this into the filler panel, and then we're going to make some marks on this paper on the other side. And I'm just adjusting this up so it fits good against the hood. And once you've got that figured out, you can lightly tighten down this knob. Then we've got the filler panel underneath. We're gonna mark right where the bottom of that filler panel meets the windshield. And then from here, we can go ahead and take the windshield back over to the bench, and we'll have this paper side facing down. Next, we're going to take the 2 thicker strips that came with the windshield, and we're going to put one end on the line we just made. It's kind of hard to see on camera, but that's exactly where it is. We can just barely see it through that paper. Verify you have this in the right spot, and then go all the way down to that bottom corner. We're going to cut the excess off. We'll remove the adhesive backing, and lay this strip in place. And we'll go do the same thing on the other side. Next, we'll take the 1/8 inch foam strip and we're gonna peel just a little bit of the backing off. And with this one, you just wanna, you know, peel the backing off as you go because we're gonna be making some corners. So we're gonna start right where this 1/4 inch strip ends. And we're gonna go all the way to the other side where the other 1/4 inch strip begins. Now we can set the windshield in place. I'm going to start by removing this protective film. Then once you have it past the notch for the knob, I'm going to set that in place so it holds everything together. And we've got that knob loose, so we can still move the windshield around for the best fitment. So once you have this where you want it, the goal is to get that bottom edge to lightly seal against the hood. So we've got that in position. Now we're gonna take the Velcro clamps and install them. So all you have to do is we're gonna wrap this around the roll cage. We'll go through that notch in the windshield. We'll loop it around this bar in the clamp. And then we're not pulling it tight yet, we're just pushing that strap back through the notch. Then once the clamp is in place, we can pull this tight, verify this is exactly where you want it, and if it's not, make some final adjustments. So I'm gonna push it down just a little bit, and we're gonna tighten it up and press that Velcro strap down. And then we're gonna do the same thing for the remaining 3 clamps. And then we're gonna lightly tighten down that knob to where it just barely presses down on that gasket. Next, we're gonna get the rear window installed. So that window comes with these clamps. You've got your hardware and the bulb seal. And right here we have the rear window. We need to get this thing ready. So I've got this on a blanket to keep it from being damaged, and we're gonna remove the protective film from both sides. Now we're gonna install the bulb seal to the bottom 3 sections on the window. And this should just press on and fit on tight. If there's any spots that don't fit tight, you wanna squeeze that bulb seal together and press it back on. Next, we're gonna remove our passenger seat and slide the driver's seat forward. Next, we have this T40 Torx head screw that we're gonna remove. It's right next to the seatbelt mount. Now we're gonna mount the L brackets into those locations on both sides. And this part sticking up, that's gonna be facing forward. I'm just gonna leave that a little loose until we have everything mounted up. To get the rear window installed, we're gonna have to come in through the cab, and then the 2 slots in the side, we're gonna work those behind the roll cage on the passenger side, and then we can do the same thing on the driver's side. Next, we're gonna install the clamps. We've already removed all of the hardware from these. We'll start by wrapping around the rubber strip. We're doing these on the top roll cage first, and we're just lining them up with the holes. And then when we install the clamp, this flat portion is gonna go against the window. So we'll put it in the correct position, install the top, and lightly install the two bolts. And then we'll go through and do all of those same steps at all of the mounting locations. Now just keep in mind, for the side roll cage clamps, this flat portion is going to be on the inside of the window. So now that you know where the rear window is going to sit, you can go ahead and straighten up these L brackets and tighten them down. Now the two bolts that came in the kit that take the 4mm Allen, we're going to take those, install a washer onto them, then we're coming through the back side of the window. You've got a spacer that goes on there. Then you're going to adjust that rear window. And then you're going to go through the L bracket and install the nut. We're going to leave these loose. We'll install the rest of the hardware all the way around the window and make final adjustments and then tighten everything down. And then for the roll cage clamps, we have the bolt and washer going through the windshield. So we did end up having to make a few adjustments with the roll cage clamps as far as their positioning on the roll cage, as well as the positioning against the window. So once you have that all set up, we're going to start at these bottom two bolts and we're going to tighten these down first. And with this hardware, you just want to snug it up. You don't want to damage the window. Then we can go ahead and tighten up the roll cage clamps and the mounting hardware. And last, we'll install the roof and tighten down the four bolts. And to get this mounted up, we're just using the existing roll cage tabs with the holes in them. So we're gonna take one of the bolts, we're gonna put a washer on it, then it's gonna go through the roof, through the spacer, and then through that mounting tab, and then we're putting the Nylock nut on the backside. And that's it for the Tusk Stage 2 Upgrade Kit for your Polaris Pro XP. If you need this kit or any other accessories for your side-by-side, you can pick those up on our website. If you have any questions about the install process, leave those questions down in the comments below. Now, if you want to see more helpful videos and content for your Polaris Pro XP, make sure you subscribe to our channel. I'm Charles with Rocky Mountain. Thanks for watching.